prayers for the USA here on Kardec Radio Live, always nourishing our souls. And we may be wondering in our intercontinental classroom, why pray for the United States of America? Why? Valid question. Because our Master Jesus, dear friends, the governor of our beautiful planet Earth, has assigned to the United States the role of being the brain of this world. And if we keep the brain oxygenized with love and fraternity and understanding, then we help the whole rest of the body, so to speak, to function well. So our Master Jesus, dear friends, is calling upon us for us to collaborate in this divine teamwork effort to let the light of the earth shine. As our Master Jesus has reminded us, we shall be able to do more than he has ever done, even more. How humble is our Master, right? But for that purpose, we need to unite and let our light shine, right, dear friends? Hi, Daisy. We just hugged each other. What a blessing. Hello, Paula. Welcome, loving and dear soul. Hello, Soul Souza. Always letting your light shine, right, dear friends? Ah, Dilson. Big hug. It's wonderful to be here, united for one single purpose, the purpose of aligning our hearts with the Christ by oxygenizing the loving brain of our world with love, so that it may, dear friends, fulfill its beautiful loving purpose assigned by the Christ, which is that of spreading fraternity, cooperation, understanding amongst all, true brotherhood and sisterhood, dear friends, the very values and foundations upon which this beautiful country was built, right? So shall we begin this loving effort with a prayer of gratitude to the Christ so that he may inspire all of our hearts? Shall we, dear friends? Yes? So let us now unite our hearts in gratitude for the Master. For the Master sustains us ever since the world was created by God. We thank you, dear Master, for being such a beautiful and loving co-creator with God, a true medium of God. And we are honored, dear loving Master, to be co-creators with you on a small scale. You have taught us to love one another and love God above all things. You have shown us that in this law lies the foundation of the very universe. So we pray so that you nourish this beautiful country, USA, with your love. And we visualize at this very moment your loving heart pumping loving vibrations of healing and light to the United States of America and spreading it out through its arteries to the rest of this beautiful world. May we nourish as we pray tonight the feeling that we are true family and that your love sees no boundaries or nationalities. Let us nourish our love for you, dear Lord, as we are certain that you are always nourishing your love for us. And in your honor, Dear loving Master Christ Jesus, we ask for your permission to begin our studies tonight. And so be it. It feels good to feel God's love always, right? And because love, according to our loving Master Jesus, is the answer, dear friends, we would like to share with all of you a message taken from the Spiritus magazine, issue 46, entitled Love. It's a message from a book yet to be published in English called Immortal Records. And it was psychographed by Chico Xavier from several spirits and published by Editora Vinha de Luz. This is published again in the Spiritus magazine, issue 46, message entitled Love. The message reads, love is the law of God everywhere. Notice above the sun that pours down a torrent of light that sustains and nourishes both the worm and the mud. Gaze down upon the vast lands, you shall find singing humble and good the spring that gives without seeking recompense, the smile of the earth that blesses. So at this point in the message, dear friends, we see a literal description of how God's love materializes itself without any frontiers, without any distinctions, in a very coherent and consistent way, reminding us that God's love is not only universal, but infinite and unconditional. We shall, dear friends, strive to align ourselves with this beautiful feeling of love, bringing our discussion, dear friends, back to the context of the world in which we live in. We would like to... Sorry, dear friends, we are back. We would like to align this message with André Luiz's message in the book Amongst Brothers of Other Lands. André Luiz tells us that we shall remember that the word foreigner at one point in our humanity, in our evolution, shall no longer exist. Wouldn't that be lovely, dear friends? Why do we say that? Because through the eyes of God, all is love. And because all is love, we shall not distinguish ourselves from one another. We shall embrace each other as family. Yes. So we shall not label a friend someone that does not belong where we are. And we shall also not as well label ourselves as outsiders. Because if we were called to live in a particular land that we were not born in, it is because we have God's green card, so to speak, dear friends. Yes, God makes no mistakes. God is calling upon us to blossom and bloom in the blessed lands where we are, right? So we all have God's green card to love life and to love the lands upon which we are in. If we are immigrants in this lifetime, it is because God is trusting our very own hearts to expand itself in a new reincarnation within this very reincarnation. How blessed we are, right? to be able to live again, to renew ourselves, to learn from the motherlands in which we are in. So the spirit mentors of Kardec Radio are inviting all of us to get rid of these labels that may be segregating us or may give us the illusion that we are segregated from one another. Because before God, all there is love. So the spirit mentors of Kardec Radio, dear friends, are inviting us to practice love, to feel love for the very lands in which we are in, to seek the good, to find its qualities, to find our place, our very own calling in this beautiful lands. Because before God, there are no mistakes in where we are. We were called upon to be in the United States of America, those of us who are here, in order to spread light and to collaborate with the Christ to send a message of infinite love, practically and primarily by living it, dear friends. So, invitation for us, how may we find love for these lands, love for ourselves, love for one another? Shall we experiment with doing what our dear Andre Luiz invites us to do, which is to actually rid ourselves from labels, since we are all children of God? Shall we? Let us continue being inspired by this message, dear friends, entitled Love. The message continues. The tree is perfect compassion without complaining of the struggle that consumes, offering the flower that beautifies and the fruits that satisfy hunger. Listen to the melody of the cradle of the maternal dream that comforts and watches the rout filled with joy, generosity, and beauty. So let us try, dear friends, to find joy, generosity, and beauty in the lands upon which we are blessed to be in. Sometimes we have a tendency to think that the grass is greener on the other side, right? But we are incarnated, dear friends, under the sponsorship of Christ Jesus, that's right, in order to find courage to spread the good. And what does courage mean, dear friends? Courage, as we learned from our friend Fred Gouveia, means feeling directly from the heart. So we are being invited to feel love, to find love, to find beauty, to find harmony in the lands of which we are in. Sometimes we long to be elsewhere, but we are being invited to find the beauty from within and where we are. Shall we? Loving these lands of the United States of America. Because if we learn to love the home that Christ Jesus has conceded to us, then we may be better able to love everywhere else. We start where we are, we bloom where we are, and we spread love everywhere we go. Right, dear friends? Let us continue then. The message reminds us of exactly that. Everything is goodness along the way. Everything vibrates, eager to help. The mountain, the forest, the field, the nest, the valley, the wind, the temple, the school, the home, and everything. Sublime love is being dispersed from the magnificent star to the larva underneath the ground. Love is the hand of God over the universe, constructing grandeur and perfection. Thus, serve and believe, pressing on. Find strength in your unwavering faith, and your heart shall remain filled with joy in harmony with our Father's love and laws. So love, dear friend, as it says here, is the hand of God in the universe. So God placed us where we are exactly to help us find love from within and also outside of us. So heart work for us, dear friends. Shall we do our best to find love for this beautiful nation of the United States of America, instead of seeking for what we may receive from the United States? Let us seek to give to the United States, because we have received so much already from God, right? And God may have placed us here in this beautiful sacred lands for us to learn to give as well. So wherever we are, let us do the altruistic movement of the foundation of the Spiritist understanding of life, charity. As Saint Francis reminds us, dear friends, let us seek to give rather than to receive. Let us seek to understand rather than to be understood. Let us seek to forgive rather than to be forgiven. Let us seek to serve rather than to be served. Shall we? What a beautiful invitation. And this is a universal invitation, because this is how we feel the hands of God in the universe. Love is the hand of God in the universe. So how shall we collaborate with the hands of God in the universe? Beautiful question for us to meditate and act upon. And after having received so many blessings, dear friends, in this opportunity to nourish our souls together, we would like to finalize our study tonight with another prayer of gratitude. Shall we? Yes? Let us visualize our Master Jesus opening his arms towards the entire world. Let us visualize the world being covered by a golden light of hope, fraternity, and kindness. Let us pray together so that from the brain of the world, Christ Jesus of the earth helps materialize bridges of friendship, of hope, of understanding, of togetherness. We pray so that the voice of the Christ is heard throughout the world, inviting us all to truly love one another. We pray so that the United States of America, the brain of this beautiful world, is infused with love, so that it may distribute love everywhere throughout this loving planet. We affirm that we trust the United States of America's divine mission. And we pray so that we too can do our part, knowing that for love there are no boundaries and there are no distinctions. that love is truly unconditional. And having felt the love of God through Christ, we ourselves receive His embrace, renewing our commitment to love and to serve always. And so be it! Thank you, beautiful friends! Thank you, Fraternidade do Bem! Thank you, Alissa Ramos, Juliana Bonatis, Tatiane Alves! Thank you so much! We shall meet again with another friend next Friday, nourishing our souls together always. And in the meantime, let us keep feeling the loving blessings of God. Thank you, Daisy. Thank you, dear friends. A big hug and many beautiful blessings always.